The first thing to note that an ablation is a procedure where catheters are put into the heart through your groin usually, under local anesthesia in most cases, but sometimes we use general anesthetic. And the point is that those catheters will map the electricity of your heart and how that electricity conducts around the heart and try and identify parts of your heart that are causing or have the potential to cause irregularities of the heart rhythm. So whether an ablation is worth the trouble or the risk, it depends on the condition that we're trying to treat. For example, in young people, we identify commonly that palpitations can be due to what we call supraventricular tachycardia or SVT. Now, we know that ablation is highly successful in those individuals, more than 99% of the individuals, with an absolute minimum risk of any major complications, such as causing problems with the structure or the function of the heart. So if I've got a young individual who experiences regular symptoms of palpitations that affect their quality of life, I would prefer to refer them to one of our specialists for an ablation rather than attempt to commence them on regular medical treatments such as beta blockers that they are not particularly effective and they will have to take for the rest of their life. The second condition that we commonly identify in about 1 in 300 individuals that we screen is accessory pathways, otherwise known as Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome. Now, for those individuals, what we will do, we will assess what the risk is, and we will do that by simple investigations such as a 12-lead ECG, a simple ultrasound scan of the heart, and an exercise tolerance test. And if we don't feel that on those basic tests we have the reassurance that the risk is low, then we will recommend that they proceed to an electrophysiological study where, as we explained before, the catheter will go in and try and map the electricity of the heart, find where this pathway, this extra pathway lies, see how dangerous that pathway is, and how easily it can be ablated. In most cases, if you've got a pathway that is very easily ablated without posing any significant risk to the individual, it will be done during the same sitting and the procedure will be curative. Other individuals that we may refer for an ablation may be individuals who get a lot of extra beats because of an underlying cardiomyopathy, but those cases are more complex. The evidence base is less solid and they should be assessed in an expert center on an individual basis.